Hello students, welcome to our next class. So in the previous class we have discussed the principles of experiment. So R.A. Fisher suggested some principles on which the design must be based on. So among those, the most three important ones are the replication, randomization and also the local control. So what is a replication? Replication means number of times a treatment is repeated is called as a replication. Randomization means in randomization all the experimental units will be having equal chance of treatment being allotted to it. That means you will be allocating the treatment to the experimental unit randomly. So whenever you apply treatments randomly, that means all the units are having equal probability of getting a treatment. Next, local control. So this local control, it is also known as the error control. So to minimize the error or to minimize the experimental error and make the design more efficient, we use the local control. So in local control, the heterogeneous material or the heterogeneous experimental area will be divided into the homogeneous blocks and then the treatments are allocated randomly. So first the whole experimental unit we will be dividing into homogeneous, that is similar blocks. Then to that similar blocks we will be applying the treatments. So that process is called as a local control by which the error can be minimized. So based on those three principles of experimentation, we are going to have some designs which are called as the complete block designs. Complete block designs. So based on the principles, there are three principles, right? So based on those three principles, we have many designs. So in that, the most commonly used or mostly used, there are only three designs which we will be studying in this unit. Now those three are the mainly used designs. So those three designs are, the first one is completely randomized design. Completely randomized design. So this completely randomized design, it is called as CRD. Next, second one is randomized block design. Randomized block design. So this randomized block design can be known as RBD. So RBD means randomized block design. And the third one, and the last one is Latin square design. Latin square design. So this Latin square design is abbreviated as LST. So these three are the most commonly used design of experiments which are based on the three principles of the experiment. So each and every design is different, which is based on different principles. So CRD and RBD we are going to study in unit 1, and coming to this LST, this LST is continued in the unit 2. So by this, by completing CRD and RBD, we can finish our first unit. So these two are the left out topics in the unit 1. So now we'll study about the CRD, that is completely randomized design. Completely randomized design. Discuss, the first one is completely randomized design, that is CRD. So coming to CRT, it is the most simplest design among all the designs. So it is the most simplest, which is based on two principles. So among three principles, this CRT uses two principles, that is replication and randomization. So CRT is based on only these two principles. So in CRT, we will be applying only replication and randomization. So coming to CRT, what does CRT means? If all the experimental units, so experimental units, in experimental material we'll be having units. So if all those experimental units are homogeneous blocks, so that experimental units are itself the homogeneous blocks on which we will be applying the treatments randomly. So first of all, our experimental units are homogeneous blocks on which we will be applying the treatments randomly with the required number of replications. That is called as the CRD, that is completely randomized design. So what is the definition? If all the experimental units are homogeneous blocks on which the treatments are applied randomly with the required number of replications. So what is CRT? The experimental units itself will be in the form of a homogeneous blocks. So if all the experimental units are homogeneous blocks, so on that units only we will be applying the treatments, right? So that units will be homogeneous blocks, and that homogeneous blocks will be applying the different treatments randomly, because we use the concept of randomization. So the treatments will be applied randomly with respect to the required number of replications. So first we will specify how many times the treatment should be repeated. So based on that only, if the treatments are two treatments, A and B, A is repeated 4 times, B is repeated 5 times. So that repetitions also will be applied randomly. So A is repeated 4 times, right? So that 4 times will be applied randomly, 1, 2, 3, 4. So wherever, whichever units randomly, they will be choosing and applying the treatments. So that is the completely randomized design definition. So this CRD cannot be used if the entire field is a homogeneous block. That means our condition itself is, first of all, our condition is experimental units should be homogeneous blocks. So if the field is not homogeneous blocks, we cannot use it. So this CRD is applicable only if the experimental units are homogeneous blocks, and there is no restrictions about placing the number of plots and the number of treatments. So here we are given based on the number of replications, the treatments will be applied randomly, right? So how many times the treatment is repeated, there is no restriction on that. So there is no restriction on the repetition of the treatment, that is replication of the treatment. So each treatment can be repeated some ni number of times. So first treatment is repeated n1 number of times, second treatment is repeated n2 times, third treatment n3 times. So there is no restriction there. Each treatment may be repeated ni number of times. So the whole experimental, so how you perform this CRD design, how the layout of the design will be there means, first of all, the whole experimental material is divided into capital M units, right? Experimental units means the number of observations in that. So experimental units, how many you will be having? Capital N, right? So experimental units, that capital N will be divided into summation Ni units. So total experimental units are capital N, which will be divided into summation Ni. That means I said Ni means number of times a treatment is being repeated. Ni times, right? So that's why total A treatment repeated 10 times, B treatment repeated 20 times. Like that we'll be getting total number of units. So summation Ni equals to capital N. And the unit subjected to the condition that ith treatment is occurring Ni times. So I said ith treatment is occurring Ni times, right? That means ith treatment is repeated or replicated Ni times. That's why the first treatment repeated 5 times, second treatment repeated 4 times, third treatment repeated 5 times. So 5 plus 4 plus 5, that will be your total number of units, that is total number of experimental units. So first thing in complete randomized design is you will be dividing the total experimental units as based on the number of times a treatment is replicated. So this is just a definition introduction about the completely randomized design. Now we will see how the layout will be there. That means how the design is there with one example. So based on that example, that means I'll consider some treatments and number of replications. Based on that, we will be designing our layout. So this is the layout. Coming to the layout, let there be three treatments. I'm assuming three treatments. So three treatments as A, B and C. So here I'm considering three treatments where A is replicated. A is replicated some 4 times. And B is replicated. So B is replicated 5 times. And similarly, the third treatment C is replicated some 3 times. So total, then what are the, for this layout, that means for three treatments A, B, C, and based on the number of treatments, only based on this example, what will be the layout, how we will draw the layout for the CRD, we'll see now. So for this, first we have to know the total experimental units. Total experimental units, that is capital N value. So capital N equals to summation over I, Ni, right? So what is Ni? Ni is the number of times ith treatment is repeated. So N1 means number of times first treatment is repeated. So N1 plus N2 plus N3, right? N1 means number of times first treatment is repeated. That is 4 plus N2, number of times second treatment is repeated. That is 5 plus N3, that is number of times the third treatment is repeated. So third treatment is repeated 3 times. So therefore N equals to 4 plus 5, 9 plus 3 is 12. So how many experimental units are there? So there are total 12 experimental units where each treatment, that is A is repeated 4 times, B is repeated 5 times and C is repeated 3 times. So for this layout, first consider the layout with 12 experimental units. So 12 means you can write as a 4 by 3. So these are the 12 experimental units. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So if there are how many experimental units are there, based on that you can write the design also. No problem. It is not necessary that you have to get square. So here I got 12, so I have written 4 by in the form of a 4 by 3 square. Now you have to apply the treatments for these experimental units. So here each box is an experimental unit, and we know CRD is applicable only for the homogeneous blocks. So here each unit, this is one unit, right? So each and every unit is homogeneous. So each unit itself a homogeneous blocks, then only we can apply the CRD. So coming to now applying the treatments, how we apply? We have to repeat these treatments based on the number of replications and should apply randomly. So we know how we will apply randomly. So here A, B, C, A, B, C we can write. So similarly like that. First come to treatment A. So this treatment A is repeated 4 times. Means in 4 units you have to apply treatment A. So apply randomly A, 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 A. So it is my wish, based on my wish, that means randomly I have chosen the experimental unit. So you may apply treatments anywhere randomly. Similarly, B is repeated 5 times. So apply treatment B 5 times. So B, 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 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 more, 5. So B is repeated 5 times. So I have applied treatment B randomly. Similarly, next C is repeated 3 times. So C, C, C. So this is the layout of the CRT, which is based on the this data only. So based on the number of replications and number of treatments, you will be having the total experimental units. And based on the total experimental units, we will be applying the treatments randomly. Now, suppose you consider some other example also. So I am giving you A, B, C. 3 treatments. So coming to layout, A is repeated 4 times, B is repeated 6 times, and C is repeated some 5 times. So here 4 plus 6, it is 10, 10 plus 5, 15. So your total 15 experimental units will be there. So you consider a layout with 15 units. Consider a layout with 15 units. So this is a layout with 15 units. So based on the number of units, we are going to consider our layout. So if you observe this, so A is repeated 4 times, apply 4 randomly, 4 times of A. Next B is repeated 6 times, B, B, so B is repeated 6 times. Similarly, next C is repeated 5 times, 4, 5. So like this we are going to give the layout for the completely randomized design. So this is about the layout of the completely randomized design. So if you observe this layout, this will be in the form of a ANOVA one-way classification. So observe carefully how you get this in the form of a ANOVA classification means. So here all the treatments are arranged randomly, right? So if I write in a format, so here there are 3 treatments, A, B, C. So these treatments, and suppose this is one field experiment, and applying the treatments, each unit will give some output. So there will be some output here. So suppose it is 1, 2, I am just giving a random number, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So that might be the output. So here you will be having the output or the observations. So treatment A, what are the observations? 1, 3, and one more is 9. Next treatment B, 5. Next 6, 7, 10, 12. Similarly, treatment C, it is 2, 4, and 8. So if you observe this one clearly, you have a one-way classification here. That means only one-sided. The output, that is the value of the random variable, is influenced by only one factor, that is based on the treatments. Because already they are, each unit is considered as an homogeneous blocks, we are not going to divide them as blocks. So only based on treatments we got the observations. So this is the first treatment values, these are the second treatment values, these are the third treatment values. So CRT is nothing but, CRT can be arranged in the form of an one-way ANOVA classification. CRT or RPT, LSD, all these can be arranged in the format of the ANOVA only. So coming to CRT, CRT will be arranged in ANOVA one-way classification. ANOVA one-way classification. So we all know how to perform the statistical analysis for the ANOVA one-way classification. So same like the CRT, same like the ANOVA one-way classification, we will be having the same steps, we will be writing the same linear model, and here we don't need to derive the statistical analysis completely. Just if you write the steps for ANOVA, then it is enough for the statistical analysis of the CRT. So this is about the CRT. And now coming to the advantages and disadvantages of CRT. So first we will look after some advantages. So coming to advantages, we know in the starting only we discussed that CRT is the most simplest design among all designs. The first one is, it is simple to implement and also to understand. The concept of replication and randomization. Replication means we know repetition, randomization means we will be applying randomly. So that's why it is very simple to understand and also to implement. And the second one is, CRT is, in the CRT we use the maximum use of the experimental units. So here the total layout, whatever we have written, it is based on the total number of experimental units, because on all experimental units we are going to apply the treatments randomly. So it is using all experimental units, that means the maximum use of experimental units is considered under the CRT. Next, coming to third one, here the statistical analysis is very simple and easy. Statistical analysis is simple and easy because we already know the statistical analysis for the one-way classification. So it is simple because if suppose any treatment value is missing also, so no need to estimate that missing value in the CRT. We don't need to, we will not estimate the missing values in the CRT. So if any value of the treatment is missing, then also we can perform the statistical analysis in CRT. So that is the main advantage. And the last one is, the design is more flexible. So this CRT is the most flexible, since many number of treatments may be it is repeated number of times also, it won't affect the statistical analysis. So here the treatment is repeated 4 times, 5 times. So our statistical analysis is not based on number of times it is repeated, right? So it is not affecting the statistical analysis. The replication or the number of treatments is not affecting the statistical analysis. So it is more flexible to use. These are the different advantages. Now we'll look after the disadvantages. So coming to the disadvantages of these are, the first one is, it is used only on homogeneous plots. It is used only on the homogeneous plots. So our main CRT itself, it is used only with, if the experimental units are in the form of the homogeneous plots. So if they are not on, experimental units are not in the form of homogeneous plots, then the CRT cannot be applicable. And next disadvantage is, this CRT is applicable only for the smaller number of treatments. So here we took 3 treatments. So it is a smaller number of treatments we can apply. 4 treatments, 5 treatments is okay. But if you consider the larger number of treatments, then performing the or giving the layout or performing the analysis for the CRT, it will be difficult. Next disadvantage is, in this CRT, we are using only replication and randomization, right? So local control principle is not used. So what is local control actually? It is the reducing the error. So hence it leads to the experimental error. So local control is used to reduce the experimental error, right? So here if you are not using local control, obviously the error is not reduced. So that becomes a drawback for this layout or the this CRT design. So this is all about the completely randomized design. So what is completely randomized design? Only remember this layout. What are the principles it uses? So in every design, which principles the design is using, you remember that one. So if you remember the principles, then only you can understand these designs. So here, completely block design, completely randomized design, that is CRT, it is based on only 2 principles, that is replication and also the randomization. So here, you will be having different treatments, and if each treatment will be repeated some NI number of times. So that treatment, based on the number of times the treatment is repeated, we are going to get our total experimental units, that is capital N value. So first we will draw a layout for all the N number of experimental units. So on those experimental units, we will be applying the treatments randomly. So based on the number of repetitions, if it is repeated 4 times, that 4 times treatment we will be applying randomly. So now if the treatment is repeated 4 times, one time treatment you apply randomly, and remaining 3 if you don't apply randomly, it is not validated. All the 4 times repeated treatment, 4 times it should be applied randomly. That is the concept of CRT. So in the next class, we will be seeing the statistical analysis for this CRT. So in the statistical analysis, we will be writing the linear model, the null and alternative hypothesis, and in next we will be writing the steps for ANOVA. No statistical analysis derivations will be there, since it follows the ANOVA one-way classification. So simply we can write the steps for the ANOVA one-way classification in our statistical analysis. So we'll continue in our next class.